Hello everyone, welcome back to yet another episode of Gravitas 24 Interviews. Today we are talking about the backbone of any event, finances. Here we have the dynamic duo who is working behind the numbers. Please welcome the finance organizers, Ms. Gayatri and Mr. Abhimanyu.
Thank you, it's a pleasure being here. I'm happy to be here, crunching numbers, cracking jokes.
I promise you guys, we're not just about spreadsheets. We have a lot of fun during night slips as well.
Yeah, so what are the work you have to do and how do you divide the work? Who does most of the part?
See, we both work equally. We split our jobs equally. And then we see to that we are budgeting and maintaining the things. I take care of the reimbursements and stuff. And he does other work.
So, like, I feel management part, like, the division of work is the most important part. So, I feel initially we discussed this with each other. And I personally manage more of the events budget. And she looks after what all payments are required for Gravitas, their sponsorship, all of that guest care. She handles all of that finances.
So, during the events, there must be a lot of last-minute changes, last-minute finances you need. So, how do you keep up with those changes according with the... not going overboard?
Yeah, last minute, no matter how much we plan or how much we do, last minute changes will be there in an event. So we basically have a buffer amount so that we see to that any extra cost will be in that. If suppose a guest wants some extra or like any juice or kind of something, and we will be in a place that we can afford it. So we just always keep some amount in a buffer.
Again, I feel buffer amount is very necessary for this. Like, there are end moment event cancellations, lot of events get added on last moment, so you require funds from somewhere to put into it. So we need to allocate that accordingly. Like, some events make a loss, so some events have surplus of money, so we just, you know, mix and match and make sure that every event goes through and not events don't get cancelled. We try our best to not cancel events from our end.
That's so true. So, how do you manage to keep with all of the needs of every department with the budget you are provided with?
Basically, we do a pre-audit where we call each POC and we ask their requirements like halls, purchase, speaker and transport. So, we just take all the incomes and inputs, and then we also take the income that they'll be getting, like the sponsorship and the registrations. We, based on that, we calculate and see to that the event is in profit. And if it is not so, we just tell them ki you reduce this so that you can afford this much.
See, I feel transparency is the key for us, because working for the finance department involves working with other domains a lot. We are working with purchase, guest care, all of these domains throughout. So I feel interacting with them, getting to know them personally on a personal level first, then discussing about work, we need data on all the events and all, and we need to keep them in loop as well, and they also need to keep us in loop. So I feel transparency is most important. Everyone should be aware of their work, because money is again one thing. If you leave out 10 rupees also, your budget, you know, you have to make it again. So I feel that is the most important part of our work.
Yeah, things need to be transparent for anything you are working on. So now for the budding like gurus who are like going into finances and have taken such big events or such big budgets, so what would be one advice you would like to give to them?
I tell them ki keep all the things tracked and maintain a proper flow through all the things. I ask them to keep a track of things which need to be done next, so that there will not be any last moment confusions or something. And as I mentioned, some last moment buffers will be there, so we'll need to have some buffer amount for that. And we should see to that the event goes smoothly.
See, again, I feel your planning is the key here. The way you plan out things. Like, I remember when we got selected as organizers, our main task was to how do we, you know, divide the work amongst the managers that we have, the coordinators and the volunteers. So I feel if you set up a plan and then move according to it, it works out for you. It does.
A solid plan needs to be there for any event you are working on.
For sure.
So before wrapping up, I would like to ask you, please give one advice you would like to give to the Gravitas attendees to how to spend money and make every penny worth.
See, I ask all the students to participate in many events as much as there's possible so that they'll have fun in events, man. So I ask them to participate in all the events and Yeah, they can click photos. Campus Decorations is also doing a great job this time. So you can click pictures, room with your friends, spend amount in stalls, man. There are many good stalls this time. So you have more fun this time in Gravitas.
I mean, we feel ki we have done a lot of work in getting in new events, preparing new stalls and everything. So I feel for a fresher, go out there, explore, because this is the first time that they get to experience such a big event on such a large scale. Like, Gravitas is one of the biggest events that we have, Tech Fest. So I feel you should go and try to explore, because honestly, next year onwards, people get involved more in the management work of it. They try to work for the Gravitas team. So I feel for a fresher's point of view, this is your year. Go there, explore all the events, find out which clubs do you like, which events you like, and just go out, have fun. That's it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your hard work. I hope Gravitas is a huge success.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
so much for your hard work behind the scenes. We won't know if you weren't here today. So that's a wrap up. Please stay tuned for more such insights about Gravitas 24.